Hello everyone. So we are at the Career Boot Camp 2023. So at the starting we have our reception over here where the registration takes place. So come, let's go on.
I said, okay, you've got your lesson of life, you've spent 1 year or 2 years, so much money of that. Now you don't want to do engineering. Whatever you want to do now, are you clear on that?
So we have our first talk for the day by Dr. Ali.
What is this BBA? Why do you like it? How did you get into it? No, people told me if you're not doing BE, then you do BBA. If you run away from something, you know, you will never be successful. You have to run towards something. So I tried out engineering, I'm not happy with it. Or I took up science, but I'm not very comfortable and I don't think I want to make a career in science. So what will be better for me? Where do I move from here? Identify, find out something better, then move out from there and move on to the thing. And individually, as I said, every person is unique, every person is individual. So you have to do it on your own. Do it on your own, take the help of parents. This is always, ideally, a parent and child teamwork. Then it really comes out that. Well, if you're at loggerheads and if you're all the time contradicting each other, then you will never be able to be successful. So make it teamwork. Between parents and children also, if you cannot, you know, find out, go to people who are experts, who know something. Don't go to people who are in particular career. You go to a bank manager and ask him, is banking a good career? If he has been happy, he has got his promotions, he is making money, he will say banking is the best career, don't do anything, it's a banking. If he has been bypassed for promotion, if he has been shuttled and transferred to some remote places, and he has suffered with a bad boss, he will say banking is the worst profession, don't take it. So don't ask them whether it's a good or bad profession. When you meet somebody, ask them, what work do you do and what are the skills required to be successful in your career? That's how. You decide whether I fit into that and I want to do it or not. And the last step, as I already mentioned to you, we have career counselors.
So we have career experts. You can come in, drop in, know about them.
Career counselors. And see them.
No, the career you would like. So we have the book stalls also set up over here. So the books and booklets written by Dr. Ali is also displayed. You can come in, purchase the books as well. So let's go to the food stall. So we saw that Dr. Ali is giving a talk on career. So meantime, let's have a look what's there for us in the food stall, right? So we have Archana over here.
Hello.
And so what are you selling today, Archana?
We are having a stall for carrot halwa, lemon tea, bookmarks, then fridge magnets and coasters.
Wow.
And earrings. So, yeah, few earrings.
That's great. So let's have a look at these.
Make and sell.
So filaments, when you say, actually it's basically a villa
Wow, that's so colorful, right? So let's move on. We have a food stalls as well. So what's over here?
It's all chaat.
Okay.
Yummy,
wow. So Bangalore weather and yummy chaats are here.
Yes.
Okay. So here we have. So what we have here?
Brownies, cake pops, pistachios, cupcakes, sandwiches.
Wow. Yummy.
We are called Sugar Cube Desserts. If you want to follow us, we are on Instagram.
Yes. So these are the paintings. So what do we have here?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is veg cutlet and bread pakora.
Okay.
So yeah.
Nice. So what we have at this counter? Amazing. Thank you. Yes. Hello, so what do we have at this counter here?
Here is all handmade soaps and candles, like brushes. Okay. We are from Handcraft Studios.
Okay, so we have Handcraft Studios over here. So we have our handmade candles, we have handmade soaps.
Yeah, lip balms.
Yeah, we have lip balms. Yes. So we have your amazing stalls, food, candles, bookmarks, paintings, and everything. So please drop in to Queen's Road at IIT Career Bootcamp 2023, held by Banjara Academy, is going on. And we have a lot of people all around, young, teenagers, everyone coming here for their career, meeting the experts in the related fields. So we have Dr. Ali here. So he's having a cup of tea. Yes, and he was having a good conversation with the students as well. We'll be soon having our FB Live as well. So today's topic is relationship breakups. We have at the reception Ms. Sujata, Ms. Nanda, Ms. Leena, and Ms. Prachi over here.
Who's going to see this video?
It's live. Look at the smiles. Yes. So our camp is fully with people. We have counselors, counseling happening, personal counseling, career counseling. So all the desks are put up, helping hands, we have our career experts. So to have the real feel of this camp, I request all of you to be here. Now we'll have our MB talk. As you know, the topic is relationship breakups. So this topic is very important. So as you know, that relationship breakups, you know, hampers our careers too. So it might hamper our career, and it's very important to take good decisions, right? Oh, hi. Yes. Okay. So starting with our every week's FB talk on Saturday, relationship breakups, we have Dr. Ali here. Yes.
I'll show you.
Maybe one more. Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. You can see Ali getting prepared for the live talk. A wonderful topic which people hesitate to open and speak about. Breakups in relationship. It's so important to address at the right moment. Otherwise, it does bring circumstances where you do introspect and do address yet. And how it affects when you are making career choices also. Yes, Ali?
Yes, very much.
Yes. So let's listen from Ali the importance of addressing relationship breakups.
Yes, good morning. It is 11 o'clock. And as you know, we start on time always. That's mine.
Okay. Sorry.
Okay, right. Let me start with giving you a little break. Background of the thing. I am being a person who has always been giving significance to relationships because I feel no other single factor determines our happiness, fulfillment, well-being as relationships. We are primarily social animals. We thrive on social interactions. We are always looking for social interactions. So what happens is that the better our relationships, and here I am talking about close relationships. See, we have casual relationships. We belong to some group, some association, some club, some neighborhood. That is one part of it. If we are happy in our neighborhood or in our association or in our office team, we interact more and more with them. But for any reason, if we are not happy with them, then what do we do? We can ignore them. You can say, I don't want to meet my neighbors. I don't want to be a member of this association. I don't want to do this. So what we do is that we ignore the people. But what happens in close relationships? We thrive more on close relationships than on the outer circle of our friendships, relationships, colleagues, acquaintances. We thrive more on this. They affect our livelihood, our life, our careers, as Sonal said just now, our well-being, our peace of mind, all that gets affected primarily by our close relationships. People who are important to us. Okay. Now, when we talk about relationships, let us understand that all relationships are dynamic. They keep changing. The people who suffer most are the people who look at relationships in black and white. They think that the only way to have proper relationships is to find that absolutely right and perfect person, starting with people who idolize their parents. There's nobody in this world who is better than my mother. I don't care for anybody. I'm willing to do anything and everything only for my mother or father or grandfather. Then there are people who put all their eggs in one basket and they say, I am now married. I have a life partner. I don't need anybody else in my life. I am so deeply in love with my partner that he or she is my friend, philosopher, guide, everything. So it doesn't matter to me who else is there or who else is wanting to be in my life or not. That is how we, you know, move on. There are so many people, for example, who even invest their entire life into their children. Even when I ask somebody, who are you? They give a reply saying, I am a mother of two children. That is a role that you are playing. You play a role as a child, as a sibling, as a partner to somebody, as a parent to somebody, as a grandparent to somebody. But those roles do not define you. Those roles are not your identity. Your identity should be the one which is there with you all the time. Relationships will not be there with you all the time. People will come and go. You have to accept it. As you grow older, you will realize, if nothing else, you lose people to death. the older you are, the greater are the chances that you will start losing people whom you loved. You get a very big shock when your grandparent, whom you love very much, passes away. But the grandparent has already spent whatever 60, 80, 90, 100 years in this world, and it was time for him or her to go. It's a cycle which goes on whether you like it or not. And as you grow older, you keep getting connected to people who are older, and therefore the chances of losing them to death are very high. So before I come to the main topic, I also want to caution you that if you lose somebody to death, there is a thing called a grieving process. Particularly if that person was very close to you and you cannot get over the death of that person. So if you are at that point where you lose a relationship due to death, please become aware that that proverb, time is the best healer, it doesn't work. Time does not heal very deep wounds the same way as with physical wounds. You get a cut on your hand and it is bleeding a little, you wash it, you be careful not to, you know, cause any trauma to it, and time heals. Before you know it, that wound is already taken care of. That's nature taking care of you. But if I have a deep wound, if my vein is cut or my bone is cut, I cannot say time is the best healer, right? I have to do some treatment to ensure that I come back to as much normalcy as possible. The same thing applies to the mental areas. So if there is a bereavement, a trauma of somebody whom you love immensely and you lose the person to that, please be aware that you have to go through what is known as a grieving process. If any one of you wants more information on that, get in touch with us. I will send you the details of how the grieving process is and how one can, you know, go to that stage of acceptance and then rebuilding after a major loss, like a death of a loved one. Now today I am going to be talking about break of a relationship, not because of death, but because things went bad. Either you realized something very, very bad about that person and said it's not worth continuing, so you have broken that relationship. On the other hand, it could also be that you like a person, you want to continue the relationship with that person, but that person breaks off from you. In either case, if you have made your efforts, if you have done whatever is needed, if you have even tried to patch it up when the relationship was going bad and you were trying to, you know, fill in the cracks and all these things, but despite all that, if the relationship breaks and you know that you've come to a point where it is unlikely that this relationship will be redeemed, if you come to that point or that stage, how do you cope with it is the question. You will come across people, you know, who go to two extremes. There'll be a young man who will be infatuated with a girl for the right reasons or wrong reasons. But you know what that person says? He says, I am willing to give my life for the sake of this person. I love her so much. Now if you love somebody, you don't have to give your life to that, give up your life for that person. Contribute towards the life of that person and the growth of that person, isn't it? But there are people who go to that extreme. After that, for whatever reason, that relationship goes sour. The relationship is not lasting and things are getting very, very bad. At that point, what happens? The same person gets so angry that he says, I want to destroy this person. I want to kill this person. I want to see this person suffer. Now see how you've gone from one extreme end to the other. And why did that happen? Because you were looking at relationships in black and white. Either you have a perfect relationship, prince and princess married and lived happily ever after, or you feel that this person has cheated me, this person has let me down, this person has been horrible to me. So therefore, I will cause harm to that person. This is the same person whom you wanted to give up your life for. Now you are becoming an enemy of that person's life. These are the points of immaturity, not being in control of your own emotions, not understanding your goals in life, not having good emotional intelligence, good EQ. These are the things which cause all these type of confusions and all that. So, primarily, if you have had even one, you know, breakup, whether it happened yesterday, or whether it happened 5 years or 30 years back, if it is still paining, if there is still a hurt, if you still recall that relationship and feel upset about it, then you need to use certain techniques. You need to do certain actions within yourself, nothing to do with the other person, to ensure that you can carry on life smoothly. Nobody's life is totally affected by one person. And more so if that one person has decided to either break off with you, or that person has shown certain such negative characteristics that you want to break off from that person. And this can happen at all levels. I know of people who say, I don't want to talk to my parent because my parent has been horrible to me. All that the parent did for years and decades gets negated, and the person says, I hate my parent, I don't want to talk to him. Of course, in romantic relationships, it happens much, much, much more. That the person feels that, you know, I love this person, I did this for that person, I did that, but that person has let me down. Therefore, I not only not want to have anything to do with the person, I want to make that person suffer. I want to see that person unhappy. These are very ridiculous things. No? So I come back to what I started with. You have to be, you know, aware of the fact that all relationships are dynamic. There is no such thing as a permanent relationship in your life. There are long-term relationships. And if you are lucky, some relationships will last till your last day. But inevitably, there are relationships which do not last till your last day. But if they are long-term relationships, or very close relationships, or you value that particular person or the relationship with that person, and if it breaks, we need to do something about it. What is that something? Before looking at the other person, you should look inward. What has been my contribution to this? In what way did I, assist that process of the breakup? How did I, make things bad for the other person? Please do that. Because barely 1% of the relationships which have broken are 100% fault of one person and 0% fault of the other person. Even if the other person is bad. 80%, 90% of the blame for the breakup can be justifiably put on that person. Even then, first look at that 10 or 20% of your contribution. Anyway, that person is out of your life. You have nothing to do with that person. So why should we spend time thinking about what that person did to you, rather than spending time thinking about where you have made a mistake, where you overtrusted the person? Maybe you put all your eggs in one basket, like I said. Maybe you ignored that person and that person became nasty with you. How maybe you became so attached to the person that you became emotionally dependent and you started clinging on, or you became possessive, and the person did what that, so the person started moving away and has now completely moved away from you. These are some of the very fundamental things that you need to think of. So if you had a breakup, however long back it was, the right time now is to sit and think, first step, what have I contributed towards this breakup? Because you are not going to have anything to do with that person with whom you had a breakup, but you are still going to spend the rest of your life with yourself. And if you don't correct yourself, you will go into a series of breakups. I've seen people going into that. One after another, relationship break. And the person gets so frustrated, the person gets so bitter, that the person starts blaming the whole world. There is no such thing as a reliable friend or reliable partner or reliable relation. Everybody is bad. Everybody is selfish. If you come to such a stage where you start thinking in that direction, there's something wrong. You are not being objective in looking at how this relationship broke. Every broken relationship should be a stepping stone towards better relationships. It should be a lesson learned, even if it's a painful and bitter lesson, but you've learned that lesson. That is why I insist that you first check what was your contribution. The second thing is to check whether because of this breakup, my confidence level has gone down, my self-esteem has gone down, my anxiety has gone up, my stresses have gone up. If anything like that is happening, if you realize that this breakup has left a big impact on you as a person, then you need to actually resolve that within you. You have to tell yourself that just because one relationship broke, it does not mean I am not capable of relationships. Just because one person was nasty to me, I can't declare that everybody is nasty or everybody is untrustworthy. Never do that, you know, generalization. The next thing to understand is that when a relationship breaks with one person, there are inevitably other people involved. You have good or bad relationship with so many others. So make sure that you are not, you know, playing to the gallery, as they say. If so and so comes to know that there's been a breakup, he will ridicule me or he will put me down. So I will do this to avoid that. No. Face it. If a relationship is broken, it is broken, and there is no point in trying to hide it from somebody. You don't go about publicizing, you don't go about, you know, advertising to the world, and definitely you don't go about telling people how nasty the other person was. That's the worst thing you can do. The more you carry that anger, that hatred, that resentment within you, the greater will be the pain and the distress in yourself, and also in the same breath, your capacity to form good relationship comes down. That's what I said. There are people who go into a series of broken relationships because they don't learn the lesson. They become even more adamant. They want to prove it. They want to challenge that, yeah, I am capable of having good relationships. And therefore, they land up from the frying pan into the fire. So that is something which I want you to understand. That breakup of a relationship should not be focused on what the other person did. I know it's difficult. I know that if somebody cheats you, somebody cuts off from you, somebody is nasty to you, somebody has a big fight with you and then walks away, it is very, very, very painful. But at the same time, it does not justify you doing things which will make it even more painful. Remember that. You have to understand that this should be a learning lesson. If you feel dependent on relationships, if you have that feeling, nobody else will love me or nobody else will make friends with me or I don't have anybody else in my life, the moment you start thinking in that direction, you cannot heal yourself and you cannot make better relationships in future, which is a very, very bad vicious cycle to get caught in. I've seen people suffering for the rest of their life because they have felt there is nobody who cares for me and nobody who likes me and whatever it is. Okay. Now let me also tell you one more important thing. I told you there may be 1% of people who are evil, who are scheming, who are fraudsters or cheaters by their very being. 99% of the people are not like that. The proof of that I'll show you. If I have a friend, very close friend or relative, and something goes wrong and I break off that relationship, I will find that there are other people who are continuing the relationship with that person and continue to praise that person and continue to have a good interaction with that person. Now when that happens, isn't that evidence for me that, you know, I had decided and I had put a label and said this person is no good. But on the other hand, I have so many other people saying that this person is good. So what does it mean? What is the lesson that we need to learn from this? The main thing is, relationships can be good or bad. People are not good or bad. Assess how your relationship is and was or can be if there's still some hope in the relationship continuing. If that is the case, then and then only you will be able to look at things in a balanced manner. Otherwise, when a relationship breaks, and if I am not in charge of my life, I have not really built up my life skills or my emotional intelligence, I focus entirely on the other person. There are people who stalk their ex-boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever it may have been the relationship. Nowadays, stalking is also done through social media. I know of people who have lost out on a relationship, gone through everything, including maybe even the legal process, and the chapter is closed. There is nothing to, none remaining in that relationship. That person is out of your life, and yet they go and check on that person's social media. They want to find out who are the friends of that person, what is the activity of that person. If you find yourself doing that, as I said, you have to heal yourself. It is not the other person's fault. The other person hurt you. The other person cheated you. The other person let you down. And the relationship broke. But you know what you are doing now? You are hurting yourself. You are causing more and more pain to yourself. Why do you want to be your own enemy? This sounds very simple and understandable in theory, but to practice it is not that easy. You have to start working on it. So like I always do, I will give you a few very simple but very practical and very useful tips and techniques. When a relationship breaks and you realize that this break is complete, there's no more hope left, there's no more of efforts to try to build back that relationship, it is not working out. The moment you come to that stage, the first step would be to protect yourself from further harm. If that person or people known to that person are in some way hurting you, insulting you, insulting you, first protect yourself from that. Refuse to be a party to any discussion with regard to that relationship. Hold your head high up and say, whatever it is over, that relationship is not there. I would rather focus on the people whom I love, who I care for, and who are my friends. I've also told you elaborately, at that point, check what was my contribution. In what way did I contribute towards this breakup? The third step would be strengthen your other relationships. Everybody has good relationships. At least 1, 2, 3 of them. Even if you're a total introvert, even if you're a very person who likes to live in solitude, you will still have 1, 2, 3 people who are close to you, who care for you, who are your genuine friends. Start strengthening your relationship with those people. Whenever the pain becomes bad, instead of doing things like stalking that person or calling up a friend and saying nasty things about that person and doing all those things, start doing stress relief for yourself. It could be prayer, meditation, yoga, whatever, gardening, music, reading, talking to a counselor, whatever ways or means, adapt so that your stress level comes down. Tell yourself that very, very useful and very nice proverb which says, this too shall pass. I repeat, this too shall pass. The worst of times that you go through always pass. And when you look back, even though the pain is there, even though the loss is there, you should be able to tell proudly, I handled myself in a mature manner. I did not do anything which I will regret or feel ashamed of. Don't allow your self-esteem to go down. Don't think of yourself as unworthy just because one specific relationship or two or three have broken or have come to an end. They are only one or three relationships compared to 30 other people whom you may have, who are important to you, who love you, who care for you, and with whom you can have a good relationship. Increase your leisure activities. Get involved in things which you enjoy doing, including certain hobbies or activities which you were very fond of, but because of various reasons, you gave it up. Get back to those. This is the time to spend, because you have more time because the relationship is broken, right? So spend more time in getting involved in those leisure activities, finding out better friends. One word of caution over here. Never get into this syndrome which is called, why me? Why do I have to suffer? Why did my relationship break? Everybody else seems to be happy. Everybody else has good relationships. Why am I the only person who is a victim? That's a horrible mental state to go into. Because if you look around, there are many, many, many people who are suffering more than you. Either they will not tell you, or you will not be aware of the extent to which they are suffering. So never compare yourself with that. If for any reason you still have to encounter or interact or face that person with whom the relationship has broken. Be very careful. Keep complete control over your emotions. Make sure that this does not affect you. Prepare and learn how to handle those moments or those incidents when you have to be face to face or you have to interact with that person. And after doing all this, the bottom line is what I keep coming back to is, whenever you find that life is really getting miserable, whenever you find that you are not able to deal with the situation, if you feel that the pain or the hurt is getting too much, seek help. Seek help from a mature, understanding, caring person who may be another close friend, may be a relative, may be an elder in your family, may be a guru or a teacher, or it could even be a counselor. But if you ensure that you do this, then you know that whatever I have to face, I know that I will be getting over this thing and I will be able to handle the situation. And no situation is irredeemable. I leave you with the same quote which I told you a few minutes back. This too shall pass. Keep repeating it like a mantra. Life will change. Good things, bad things will come. The more you learn to face stress with least distress, the best will be your thing. And use this breakup as a stepping stone to build better and stronger relationships. Right? So with that, I take my 1 minute tea break and I hand you over to Sona.
Hello everyone. I was listening to Dr. Ali on relationship breakup and I felt it is such a sensitive moment or those phase when people go through breakup, and I think even if that person doesn't come up and speak to you, how much can you give that unspoken support to that person does make a lot of difference in their life. Yeah? Okay. To tell you what's happening today at Institute of Agricultural Technologies on Queen's Road, as you saw right in the beginning when we went live, there is a career boot camp happening over here from Banjara Academy. Yes? And the relationship between breakup and career is too close, because it does affect you. If suppose your partner has been in the same stream of yours, you may start disliking the choice that you have made about your career, or disliking that subject where you are commonly sitting and studying. You never know, but it does affect you some or the other way. So do address these issues. Make sure it doesn't affect you on the long term. Take help from your near ones, dear ones, or the counselors. Yeah. And as I was telling about the career boot camp, we are here at Queen's Road, IAT, till 1 o'clock. So if at all you think you want to come and speak to us in person, it may be regarding the relationship breakup or regarding career, or you want to know more about Banjara, or you want to do some psychological assessments to understand what is my love quotient, how do I manage my anger, am I even getting angry, am I an anxious person, what's happening with me. All those assessments are completely free. So if you think you want to be a part of it, just start your, booking your auto or cab and come and be a part of it. And apart from that, we do have some fun games also. Everything related to mind and brain. It's just an amazing morning. And in the afternoon, we have our 25th batch of Diploma in Counseling Skills to be getting inaugurated. The people who are part of Banjara and who have done their Diploma in Counseling Skills will be so excited to know that this year is the 25th batch. Isn't it amazing that, you know, so many counselors are there around to help so many people in need. We just need to stay connected and connect the people in need. So Ali is back after his break, and I will read out, I think two or three of them have posted certain concerns, so I'll read out for you, Ali.
Yes,
and
please.
Ali will answer those.
Yes. Always a pleasure to not only answer those, but also to learn from those. I get such wonderful insights when you post things on the chat box.
Yeah. Asha Chandra Prabha has written that in this journey of life, we play many roles, yet man is alone.
Yes, that's a very philosophical thought, Asha. But remember, there's a difference between solitude and loneliness. Many people succumb to loneliness when there is a relationship breakup. And most of these people are those who have put all their eggs in one basket. If I decide that my life revolves around my child, or I'm 100% committed only to my life partner and I don't care for anybody else, or if I feel that for the rest of my life I have to do nothing but take care of my parent, that is when, if that relationship breaks or even becomes sour, becomes unpleasant, you go into loneliness. But if you have learnt solitude, like Asha said, you know, primarily we are alone. Alone does not mean lonely. Aloneness can also be solitude. So I have friends. For me, for example, some of my best friends always, inevitably, are books. Some of my best friends are fantastic songs and music from the retro era. There are songs which I can listen to 100 times and still feel connected and still feel attracted to those songs. So when that happens, you will be alone, but you will not be lonely. You will not go into depression. You will not wonder what happened to your life and why this is happening.
So yeah, instead of fighting against it, go with the flow is what you say.
Absolutely.
Wonderful, Ali. And now Shobha Kumar Swami has written that my friend lost her heavy, drunken husband 1 year back. She's suffering and getting pain, but she doesn't share anything with anyone. She has no aim in her life and she has 2 children to take care of.
Very sad, Shobha. And if you really care for that friend and if there is something that you would like to do about it, I'll give you a few quick tips and then we can discuss personally one-to-one. You can call me and we can have a more detailed talk on what you can do for this friend of yours. The first thing is, be there with the friend without forcing her to talk. If you keep telling her, you must talk about your life, you must say this, you must reply, how do you feel? And for some reason she has clammed up, she will go further into her shell. So just be there. Make some nice positive strokes. Give some nice comments. Oh, I remember long back, you know, you had given that wonderful party and you had cooked so well. Or I remember that time when we had all gone out together, we have such lovely memories. And the next step is to slowly bring her focus onto her children. Life moves on. Her husband is no longer there. In her case, as you said, it may even be, you know, extremes of emotions. If it had been a very loving, caring, close, you know, bond between husband and wife, then she would have had clear emotions of loss, pain, suffering. But if for some reason the husband had some bad habit or he was doing things which she didn't like, then the anger is still there. It has not gone away because he is no more. So you need to understand why she is probably not willing to talk about it. Because if she says bad things, people say, oh, he is dead. How can you talk bad things about him? And she has no good things perhaps to talk. So take her away from that topic. Take her towards things which she likes to do or used to like to do, and primarily take her to her children. Start talking about children. Offer a little bit of help. I think your child likes to draw. I was thinking I'll get some crayons and some paper and I will see this. And will you tell me, you know, whether he is responding to this and whether he is drawing? Keep reminding her that she is now the only parent to these children. They deserve to have their parent, the one and only parent, and upbringing from her. So make her understand, and at the same time make her understand that connecting to your child or children will give you joy. Don't think of it as a responsibility or as a duty. Think of it as something very happy which is still there in your life and which will probably continue till the end of your life, because you will in normal course die much before them. So even till your death they will have that. So these are the things you can start off with. Depending on how she responds, you know, we can discuss how to take it further.
Asha Chandra Prabha also is asking something, Ali. Isn't it true that when man is alone, that man begins to think, what will I do with my life? How will I progress? How can I contribute to the society? Does these questions come normally to anyone and everyone?
No. It doesn't come very normally. It doesn't happen to everybody. There are people who, when they are alone, they go towards solitude. And they start introspecting. And they think, okay, today is a free day. I have no other responsibilities. I have nobody around me. So let me do some introspection. What were my aspirations and ambitions long back? How much did I achieve and how much did I not achieve? Where am I headed from now? What are the issues which are still hurting me or the baggage that I am carrying? What are the things which I can and capable of doing but have not done it so far so I can go ahead? These are the wonderful people who really benefit from that solitude. But also be aware, there are people, the moment they are alone, they become so desperate that they reach out to the one and only thing to solve their problem. Before you know it, they pick up the mobile. If there is somebody to talk to, they do that. If they are on innumerable social media group, they start, you know, browsing through and checking who said what, 90% of which is of total gossip and of no concern. If that is not there, then they start browsing at memes and this and that and some blogs and vlogs and all these
YouTube videos.
Now these are the people who are trying to run away from loneliness, and loneliness will keep chasing them.
It's so important to address these issues.
These are the issues which we have to keep in mind, that, you know, good relationship, bad relationships do happen. Today I didn't discuss about salvaging a relationship which is going bad, because that's a topic by itself. If you need to salvage a relationship which is still going bad, we will discuss that. In fact, as we were talking, the thought struck me that maybe one of these Saturdays later, we'll have a topic on that. That when a relationship seems to be slipping away from your grasp and you don't want to let it go, how do you handle it? Similarly, if you feel a relationship is getting bad and you don't want to hang on to it, how do you let it go most gracefully without making it unpleasant, without making it problematic either for you or for that other person? So that's the other thing that we need to, you know, look into.
Ali, I have one question.
Yes.
I was just thinking about our last week topic, live-in relationship, and today's topic, relationship breakup. If suppose somebody is in a live-in relationship and it's not going good, and family support is not there just in case, because they have just walked out for that. In such a case, what do you think that person should be doing?
Yes, like any other relationship, I would not set apart a living relationship with any other, because relationship is more to do with your emotions than the physical act of living under one roof or being married to each other or having a legal born like father and son or anything like that, okay? So if that is the case, You need to introspect. That's exactly what I was telling you a minute back, that you need to be aware of relationships which are going bad. And if it is a very close relationship, like a person whom you love, with whom you have a live-in relationship, or even if you are married to that person for that matter, we need to start introspecting much before it becomes a crisis. That is the mistake that we make. We wait till the building catches fire and then we go running to find a fire extinguisher. If you buy a fire extinguisher, keep it charged, learn how to use it, ensure that it is kept at a place where it is easily accessible. You are assured that if any fire breaks up in that relationship, within minutes you can douse it and you can continue with your routine life. These are the things that we need to keep in mind. Okay, Shobha says, as your student, I didn't ask any curious questions. I did as you have just told me. So proud of you. Yes, Shobha, we are also proud of you. I personally am proud of you. Whenever I see some of our students, you know, growing, evolving, finding their own path, I personally believe that the best teacher is one who creates students who overtake the teacher and become far better. And let me tell you, so many of our Banjara students have done that. Today, I really admire and respect them for what they are. And the interesting thing is, I also learn from them. There is so much I have to learn from them. Every time that there is some interaction, I learn in some way or the other. I was having a discussion yesterday with one of our old students who is now a faculty with us, Archana. We were talking about behavioral economics. Now, she has put up a stall here in this career fest which is going on. Among various other things, she has also brought a sweet, a carrot halwa. I was telling her that a behavioral economist would say, have at least one more sweet. Because if a person comes and is wanting to eat, but finds that the only thing available is carrot halwa, even if I like it, I don't like the idea that I don't have a choice. If I want to eat, I have to eat only carrot halwa. If I don't want to eat that, then nothing else. So I told her, get at least one more sweet. So when a person has, you know, two choices, person feels in control of his life and says, yes, I don't want that other sweet, I want carrot halwa. You see how people get boosted up. At the same time, behavioral economists have also told us that don't offer people too many choices. Then they get very confused. And they sometimes get so confused that they don't buy any of the sweets and they move on from there and maybe they'll go to the bakery and buy some baked stuff. Simple things in life, simple lessons of life. On a day-to-day basis, we keep learning these lessons. And I'm really happy, privileged and proud of the fact that we have such wonderful people who, in a common term, we call them Banjarites. They may be student, they may be former student, they may be faculty, they may be volunteers in helping hand. There are so many roles. There are those who disappear and you suddenly meet them years later. And the way we connect back to them is like, you know, having a long lost sibling or somebody who had gone away for years and has come back.
Ali, can I interrupt?
Please.
You said Banjarites as we are having this 25th batch. But before that also you were having the helping hand wing. Can you roughly give a figure how many Banjarites or can possibly be there in the family?
Oh my God. I really have no idea. But if you want me to make a wild
guess.
Yes. I think we should be nearing somewhere near 10,000.
Wow.
That is the number that I would make a educated guess on. And the number continues to increase because not only those who learn from me or from the faculty of Banjara, a lot of people who learn from each other. I know so many who connect, interact with each other and their learning goes on.
From here they go on to better learnings, better teachings, better teamwork. Each of them makes me proud of them, and that's what I always look out to and feel proud about. So the same way, I feel extremely happy that every week, Saturday after Saturday, those of you who take time off at 11 o'clock and spend this time with us, or with me rather, particularly, I truly feel privileged, and I truly want to thank you all, including the thousands of people who watch later because the time is not convenient. Each one of them matters to me. I have never ever given, you know, importance to numbers. I don't say I want 1,000 people or 10,000 people to follow me or to, you know, listen to me and all that. If there are 5 people listening to me and out of those 5 2 have benefited and their life has improved, I am more than happy with that. So as we do every week, once the questions are over, we don't hold you back till the noon bell rings. We will now wind up and we will, you know, end this session with the promise that I will be back with you next Saturday, which is the 1st of July at 11 o'clock. Thank you.
And thank bye-bye. You for the compliments to Ali. I will thank on Ali's behalf too, because being a part of Banjara, I know the value of it. And so many of you here in the live also know the value of it. That's why we have taken this 1 hour of time and thought of listening to him. There are many who are not maybe right now live, but do follow what they have learned, unlearned in diploma in counseling skills. So if you think there is anybody whom you think can benefit from our diploma in counseling skills course, admissions are going on yet, please tell them to come, understand, and then take their own decision by themselves. So bye and see you next Saturday. Bye Jayati. Bye everyone.